All hell a beard, it's your boy Big BB, and we back for another edition of Big Beard Business. Today is Sunday, which means we are back for another weekly fragrance rotation video. We on week number 54. Yes, man, 5-4. We've been doing this for a long time. And thank you guys for rocking with me. For those of you who tune in faithfully, I appreciate it. And for those of you wondering, the Frag Ranch will be back. And look, man, don't think that we like slacking on these videos. We had some unforeseen circumstances and technical difficulties make it a little bit difficult for us to get these videos out. But I'm here recording content. Gonna get it to you one way or another. You gonna get it. So let's get down to what we're here for. For those of you who are familiar with this channel, what we do is we talk about the fragrances that I wore this week. We talk about the compliment factor or lack of compliments. We talk about the weather and anything of importance. But most importantly, you comment down below. You let me know what you wore this week and how it performed. So without any further ado, let's get into it and let's do it. So if you've been around the channel for a while, then you know that sometimes I do these weeks dedicated to people, places, or things. But this time we have Parfum Vintage, man. I did a whole week dedicated to Parfum Vintage. It kind of happened by accident. By the second day or third day, I was like, okay, I might as well do a whole full week of it. So here we are. So on Sunday, I kicked off the week with the fragrance that released this year, and I think I did an unboxing video, or at least a first impressions video on it, and I will get you a full review here soon. I know I say that all the time, but I will definitely get you guys a full review soon because I get a lot of questions about it, and obviously it comes from the house of Parfum Vintage, and this one is X Batch Intense. Now, as the name implies, X Batch Intense is a more amped up, more intense version of X Batch, which I believe released in 2018, and that one kind of combined two fragrances, Sauvage and Aventus, and this one takes a little different approach than the original. Now, on Sunday, I had limited interactions with people. In fact, outside of my house, I really didn't have any interactions. I just went to the bank. I did 4 sprays on this one. I got 0 compliments, and again, man, I wasn't really around people, so I wasn't really expecting any compliments. Now, on Monday, I poured out another fragrance from the house, and this one is one of my favorite releases from 2018, and definitely one of my favorite releases from the house. This one is Intrigo Devastante Intense. Now, I've talked about this one a few times because I enjoy it, and this one is a recreation, a reinterpretation, if you will, from Dolce & Gabbana by Man. That one was discontinued years ago, and they came out with this one. In my personal opinion, this is the best way to do a clone or recreation of a fragrance. Those ones that you can't get anymore, that batch, that just that, you know, that one, that je ne sais quoi, man. I don't know. There's just something about this fragrance that I do love. It brings back a lot of memories from my childhood, even though this one isn't the original from my childhood. Like, you know, when I was a kid, when I was younger, all right? This one brings back a lot of memories from those times. This one is one that I truly enjoy from the house, and I do love wearing it, and I wear it when I can. I guess overall, it would be very important to tell you what I wore. So I did 4 sprays of this one. It was 80 degrees. I got 2 compliments with this one, and again, I really enjoy it. It has nice staying power, so if you're looking for a fragrance that you can pull off in the spring and summer with good staying power that's a tad bit different than what you'll smell on a lot of people out there in the marketplace today with these fragrances that are releasing, I think that's one you should try out. Now, on Tuesday, I poured out the King. Yes, man, King from Parfum Vintage is what I wore. Now, it was 80 degrees outside. I did 4 sprays on this one, and I got 0 compliments. But in my personal opinion, this is a very, very solid release from the house. And for the price point, I mean, when you compare it to, obviously, Aventus and some of the other fragrances that are out there, those more expensive, like Aventus-like fragrances out there, this is definitely a nice one. Now, if you are not a fan of Pineapple Vintage Intense, that one comes off, in some people's opinion, a little bit more harsh than this one here, then this one may be a good one to go for. In my personal opinion, I think that this one is a good balancing act between the lowly acts of Armoff. I mean, I guess that would be weird to say, but it's not like as cheap smelling as Armoff. It's not quite there at Aventus, but it's high on that level, in my personal opinion, in terms of, hey, is this a quality smelling fragrance? And yes, I can tell that the quality is placed in this one. So there you have it. On Tuesday, I wore King. Now, on Wednesday, I poured out a fragrance that had pink pepper, juniper berries, lime, bergamot, thyme, you name it, it kind of has it all. And this one is Evolution de l'Homme Matin. Now, this is one of two fragrances released from the House of Parfum Vintage that paid kind of homage, if you will, to Elysium by Roja Dove. These are recreations. It took pieces of that fragrance and kind of made different parts of that fragrance amped up in each one. I do enjoy the fragrance overall, for the most part. The pink pepper to me is strong in the initial spray. I like the other one a tad bit better. I'll probably do like a side-by-side comparison on the two of those fragrances. But again, definitely one that you can get that really smells similar to those and kind of, you know, really amps up the best pieces of the original fragrance. Now, to me, I wasn't a huge fan of the original, even though it's very natural smelling. I wasn't a huge fan of it. But I do think these are some good creations based upon that fragrance, the original one. But nonetheless, I think if you're looking for a fragrance that fits that type of vibe, you should be good to go. Now, it was 80 degrees on Wednesday. I did 4 sprays on this one and I got 0 compliments. Out the gate, again, that pink pepper was, you know, right there. I could smell it's quite strong, and I could smell it actually through the atomizer here, and I haven't really sprayed that one since Wednesday. So if you're into pink pepper in that top note, it's right there ready to go for you. So on Wednesday, Evolution de l'Homme Matin. Now on Thursday, I poured out a fragrance that I haven't worn in quite some time. I believe this one was a 2017 release and one that smelling it again, man, I really do enjoy it. This one is Suave, obviously from Eau de Parfum Vintage. And this one was like a recreation of the original formulations of La Nuit de l'Homme. And I really, really enjoy this one. I did 5 sprays. It was 80 something degrees outside. I did not get any compliments. I wore this one during the day. Key points here. The performance on this one is far, far better than the bottle of La Nuit that I have. So I'm not really sure what year that one's from, but this one does smell great. And I think it really smells better than the one that I have. So a lot of people gripe about the price on this one, but if you really kind of compare it to what you're getting in those watered down formulations of La Nuit de l'Homme right now, then I think that this is probably the better buy. It's a bit more expensive than some what you could find La Nuit out there for, but if you're really into performance, not reapplying throughout the day, and you want something that smells great along those lines, then that's one you should definitely try out. On Friday, I wore fragrance that's vanilla and pineapple. You guys know what it is. This one is Vanilla Intense from Eau de Parfum Vintage. And this one, again, is like an Aventus type of vibe with vanilla added. Now, if you're familiar with the house, then you know that this company pretty much does a ton of different reinterpretations of Aventus, the different batch variations. They go through and they kind of find the best ones that people are really looking for. And then they kind of change them up a bit and make them their own and then present them to the public, right? And this one is done just like that. And I do like that added note of the vanilla in here. I like it. It's amped up. It's ready to go. And I think this one is a dope fragrance. Now, performance on this one isn't the best performance overall, but it's not bad. I like it. It got me 1 compliment. It was 83 degrees outside and I did 5 sprays on that one. I think when you look at Parfum Vintage and what they're doing out there and really trying to make the people happy and give them the batches of Aventus that they really, really liked, and kind of recreating those pieces and those elements of those fragrances out there and present them to you for a fairly reasonable price. And I think that it's dope. Now, I'm not one personally to go out there like, you know, batch chasing, but if that's your thing, man, if you like a specific batch of Aventus, then, you know, find out which one kind of falls on that line. And if you can't buy it, then get one of these, man. And then finally on Saturday, I wore a fragrance that I believe is either a late 2018 or early 2019, even though it's still early 2019 release from the house. And this one is a recreation of Bond number 9 Bleecker Street. And this one is Exaltante Le Musc. Exaltante, I forgot what it's, I guess it's right there. It's the Eau de Parfum concentration. I did 6 sprays on this one, I think. Yeah, I did 6 sprays of this one throughout the day. It was 85 degrees outside. And here in Florida, man, it's gearing up for those spring temperatures. And it gets hot here, like really hot. This one is a super solid fragrance, in my personal opinion. It's solid, more solid than the original Bond, right? So to me, that opening on that Bond is kind of like very, it's musky, right? It's very musky, a little bit too musky for me. Even though I do own it, I feel like this one is a better opening overall between the two fragrances. So I like it. I think they have two versions of this one. I gotta go through all the stuff that I have in there for them. There's an intense version and the regular one, I believe. Don't quote me on that. I'll leave it listed below. That's what I wore this week, and I guess I have to go through and pick out a winner. What won for you this week? What took the cake overall? I think Intrigo Devastante Intense was the actual winner in terms of compliments, with two compliments this week. So Intrigo Devastante Intense is a winner, and that's pretty much a carryover from last year as well, because it got me a lot of compliments in 2018. I appreciate you guys tuning in. Again, comment down below. Let me know what you wore this week, what performed the best, and I believe that the fragrant will be coming back next Sunday. So if you want to be featured in that, you know what to do. As always, I'm your boy, Big Beard Beat. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Tell a friend to tell a friend that we are back again. And do me a favor, as always, hit the goddamn